Henry, how would you describe this double act?
Yeah, well, are they a double act? That's the question.
My business partner and I have been watching you from our apartment on Baker Street. Your sister has a gift. She can see things normal people cannot.
That's the doctor's name.
John.
John Watson. He knows much more than what he's telling us.
I absolutely love the series, but I guess, first of all, what do you think The Irregulars brings to the world of Sherlock Holmes that we've not seen before?
For so long, we've had Sherlock Holmes as this charismatic, confident man who can solve any case. And as much as that's still there in this, I think there's a new side of it, side that we haven't seen before of Sherlock Holmes. And I think it's interesting to kind of delve into and to see how somebody that strong and that powerful in stature can kind of get broken.
The sort of irregular Baker Street gang are only mentioned about four or five lines in the Arthur Conan Doyle books. And Tom Bidwell, our creator, has done an amazing job of sort of drawing from those Sherlock stories and those characters and implanting them into the Irregulars world. And yeah, as you said, it's a story that we've not really seen before and characters we really know nothing about.
I think it's a new combination of elements that we haven't seen in the world of Sherlock Holmes before. It's not the traditional kind of mantelpiece drama, as it were. There's a new level of threat and peril, I'd say.
The Victorian London which we operate in is kind of crazy. Like, it's Sherlock amped up. And, like, what would happen if we made things a bit more, pushed things in the more supernatural direction? But then still have a sort of grounding in the real world through some sort of very real characters.
Thaddea, the sets and costumes look pretty filthy and authentic. Did you get the stench and feel of Victorian London on the set?
We actually didn't have any costume and makeup departments. That's all just us dealing. we had an incredible departments. Edward Gibbon and Lucy Civic, who were just phenomenal. Their creative minds created this beautiful, really rich world. I did go home for Christmas and my daddy picked me up at the airport. And before he said, "Hello, how are you?" he said, "Do you not wash your ears?" Because I had dirt like lodged in them. And he was like, "What's wrong with you?" And my mom was like, stop, just give her a hug.
Royce, what were the sets and the costumes like to live and breathe?
I mean, they were fantastic. I mean, these things really help. And the more, you know, you can be in that world, the better it is. And we had some incredible sets and some fantastic costumes. And you know what's great about this one is it blends the rich and the poor, the old money and the no money. And I think it's you get a sense of both worlds, and when characters kind of blur these lines and cross these lines. And Watson as well, you know, he's high society, but he feels like he has to mix to get what he needs.
Darci, your character is particularly connected to the kind of fantasy and supernatural element in the show. How big a challenge was it?
I think, you know, we had so many brilliant sets and they really did build a lot of it. Especially my character has these nightmare scenes and they built all the tunnels around me. So it really was not that hard to imagine the kind of world that I was, you know, being in, because the sets are so incredible. And then we did do a lot of green screen work, but they actually had a monitor on the side that we could see what would be on the green screen. I really enjoyed kind of venturing into the kind of sci-fi world. It's cool.
And this is a sort of darker, more complex and sort of tangled up view of these chaps from Baker Street. It's not just two pals solving crimes and getting in trouble.
I think it's a fractured and kind of flawed pairing in our world. So we're trying to work out to what extent they can even function, both as individuals and certainly as a team.
This is just the beginning.